I am most powerful when I wrestle in the spiritual realm with my spiritual weapons. All right, so let's get into this word tonight. Whereas you may not have the ability to entirely avoid environments where there are contaminants, you do have the wherewithal. Let me explain that too. I mean, you can wear gloves, you can wear a mask, you can put on all sorts of stuff to protect you, but except God is really keeping you in your stewardship of acknowledging the protocols that you should acknowledge, you still need God to protect you, or the virus will get you somehow. You want God to protect you even where you are weak or where you fail to cover an area. Whereas you may not have the ability to entirely avoid environments where there are contaminants, you do have the wherewithal and ability to strengthen your immune system so that it can withstand and even reject the invasion of these contaminants. I'm in both realms now. Please, y'all stay with me and take notes. Everybody's waiting on the vaccine. Pfizer, according to the international news in America, says they got a vaccine that's 90% safe. And that's cool. I hope it's true. I hope the vaccine is safe. And all the crazy conspiracies that I've been hearing concerning this vaccine, I hope that's not true, even though I don't intend to get any vaccine. What I want to say is this, is that what we should be pushing and pressing in this hour is encouraging the citizens of the world to strengthen their immune systems. Strengthen your immune systems so that in the event that a virus or a bacteria slips into the eye, nose, or mouth, your immune system is so strong that it will reject the impact of the virus. Are you hearing me? Strengthen your immune system, which means in the natural realm, make sure you're taking your B12. Make sure you're taking your D3, especially if you don't get sunlight. They say in the western part of the world, you shouldn't need D3 because we have so much sun. But the truth of the matter is, we got AC in the homes, most of us. We got AC in the job. We got AC in the car. And when we have to walk from the car to the house or the car to the job, we run quickly because we don't want any sun to get on us, which means we're not getting the maximum amount of D3, which helps to strengthen our immune system. So you get your B12, you get your D3. Some people do the zinc. And if you're here in the Bahamas, that we have this thing we call the bush medicine, where we drink the things that we need to strengthen our iron, to strengthen our resistance. And I'm not going to go into all of it tonight because I just wanted you to get the spirit of what I'm talking about here so that your mindset is, I am going to strengthen my immune system. And I'm not going to do it just once because it's the cold season now. No, I'm going to be diligent. Because the season that we're entered into requires consistency. What God is allowing for us, the strong amongst us who remain in this hour to represent Him, He is encouraging us to be strong both in the natural and the spiritual. And the key to it is consistency. When you keep putting the right stuff in your system. Oh, this is good. This is good. I don't know if I'm going to finish this tonight. I get a lot of notes. You have to be diligent. Make sure you're feeding your physical body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, with the right foods, because it has long been discovered that the body that is alkaline within is the body where diseases can't live. And because there's two levels of conditions in your body, you can either have a very acidic body or you can have a body that's alkaline in nature. What makes your body acidic? Eating a lot of junk. Eating a lot of junk food, eating a lot of red meat, eating a lot of pork, eating a lot of meat, period, and drinking the wrong stuff. And so the inside of your body is very acidic, and so viruses will love to come in your body and live and be strengthened in that kind of environment. If you want to kill the effect of viruses, and I'm still in the natural here, what you do is you want to make your body as alkaline as possible. Eating as much green, natural green things, organic things that you can. Making sure you're getting the necessary vitamins in your system that keeps you strong. There are some people who go the entire year and never even have any symptom of a cold or a flu. We're pushing to walk in that kind of strength in our bodies with regards to our immune system consistently. And I'm coming now to take it to another level where we have that same as it is in the natural. It is in the spiritual realm. If you're going to make sure that you're going to the gym, you're walking 30 minutes, you're taking your B12 and all of your vitamins, your D3 and whatever else you're taking, you're going to do all that for your physical body and not make sure your spiritual body is in the same kind of shape or better? Are you crazy? This is the hour of consistency and balance. If I want to be careful what I put in my physical body, I also need to be careful what I put in my spiritual body. For the most part, we enter the things that needed for our bodies through the mouth, for our spiritual body, those things enter in through our eye gate and our ear gate. What am I watching? What am I listening to? Because that's how I feed my spiritual immune system. Listen to the line again. Whereas you may not have the ability to entirely avoid environments where there are contaminants, you do have the wherewithal and ability to strengthen your immune system so that it can withstand and even reject the invasion of contaminants. As it is in the natural, so it is in the spiritual. Here's a question. What is the purpose of the immune system? We're in study tonight. I hope you are in your study mode. The immune system has a vital role to play. It protects your body from harmful substances, germs, and cell changes that can make you ill. It is made up of various organ cells and proteins. The body of Christ has an immune system as well, designed to protect the body from harmful substances. This system is made up, listen to this because you need to get this, it is made up of the blood of Christ, the word of God, the armor of God, the ecclesia, the government or the church of God in the earth, and this ecclesia is also made up of the fivefold ministry gifts, which I talked about on Sunday, I didn't label them all for you, but the fivefold ministry gifts, the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor, the teacher. These gifts have been given to us to help to strengthen our spiritual immunity.
Hi, friends. Thanks for watching another episode of Truth Unleashed with Ambassador Devin Roll. Be sure to follow us on Facebook and YouTube. We're also on Twitter and LinkedIn. Stay connected.